You're watching Game Show Network.
Get ready to match the stars from Password Plus, Tom Kennedy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from the Lawrence Welk Show, Gail Farrell, McLean Stevenson, and Joyce Dunavant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
Thank you for joining us here in the Match Game. All right, John.
Listen, honey, one of us is wrong. I have that jacket. Now, I'm not casting aspersions. Don't misunderstand me, but, I mean, one of us is...
Just because I wear a houndstooth jacket does not make me a bad person. And, in fact, the lecture today will be on the anthropological studies done in the 18th century by, hello.
Hello.
No, I'm only kidding about that. I guess I haven't lost enough weight yet to wear it. The thing buttoned. I'll just have to unbutton it and wear it casual.
So you can breathe.
Yes. Let's say hello to Larry Bowles and Elizabeth Augustine. Applause, applause, applause. Now, just to refresh your memories, Elizabeth is a newlywed, about a year.
That's right.
And she has an anniversary, a wedding anniversary, and a birthday anniversary coming up about a week apart.
That's right.
And she lives around here somewhere, right?
I live in Los Angeles. I'm originally from St. Paul, Minnesota.
That's right. I was king of the winter carnival there
you
one
were.
Year. Yes.
Have you thought out yet?
Yes.
It was a marvelous
it's
experience.
Cold.
I really liked it.
Yeah.
I mean, all that ice sculpture they do is very handsome. Great place. And Larry Bowles here is a Presbyterian minister.
Right.
In Covina.
Uh-huh.
Has two children.
Right.
Is your wife here?
Yes, she is.
Good. She's
Her
rooting for
Linda.
You.
Uh-huh.
Linda?
Where
are you, Linda?
Where?
Hello there. Welcome. He's doing okay, isn't he? Got $500?
No.
All right, let's start here. 1-0 in Larry's favor. This is the last round of the last game. And since you're ahead, Larry, you must go first.
A.
It is. Rick said, I'll never go back to that lousy bar again. I asked for a scotch, so the bartender strained a beer through a blank. Waiting for you, Gail. Here we go. Rick said, I'll never go back to that lousy bar again. I asked for a scotch, so the bartender strained a beer through a blank.
What's that thing that a Scotchman wears around his,
How do I know?
You know that little
it's
skirt?
Here it is, friends. It's show-and-tell time in the third grade. Stand up and do show-and-tell.
You know, that skirt that they wear. What
that
is it?
That skirt that they wear. That skirt that they wear. That's your answer.
Well, what is it called?
What is it called?
Kilt. A kilt.
Right. Okay.
A kilt.
His answer is kilt.
Hmm.
All right.
Told you.
Hmm. What'd you say, Tom?
I started from the top. And I didn't get that far down.
Oh, really?
I stopped right at the tam o' shanter.
Oh, a tam o' shanter. Oh,
yeah.
It's a lovely touch, yes.
Thank you.
What
hold
have
it
you
down,
got
please.
Yes.
See, again, the camera caught me looking over there, and I've been doing it for years, and people think I'm not paying attention. I look at the monitor.
Yes, see? I know. We're going to have to move it.
No, you don't have to move it.
Why do you look, Charles?
Well, I just like to see how it's going. You know what I'm saying?
It's going okay, trust me.
I never heard of it. What are those?
Kilts.
Oh, I didn't kill.
All right. All right, so Larry, you have two now. I asked for a scotch, so the bartender strained a beer through a what?
Just before we came on, I had a frontal lobotomy, so I'm not sure about this answer. Because I know what I meant, but I don't think I got all the words in.
Well, you see, there a tartan is... is one of the different designs.
Of the
is one
I
of the
know,
designs.
But a tartan plan.
No. A tartan is not a lady of the evening.
Oh, that's
you right. Rascal.
You cut off the two last ones.
All right, McLean.
In keeping with the rest of my performance for this week.
Yes, sir.
And not having understood one question, I answered by saying napkin.
Napkin?
Why?
Now, I heard key words. There's something happening to me here because I've heard key words like strained.
Yeah.
Scotsman. Scotch.
Scotch.
Here.
Lousy bar.
Yes.
Asked for a scotch. So yes. The bartender strained a beer through a kilt would be a wonderful answer.
Did anybody say that?
Oh, yeah. Several people have said it.
But, well, I knew I'd heard it somewhere. But napkin was my choice.
Napkin, okay. Well, it could have been a tartan plaid napkin and something like that.
Yes.
All right, Joyce, have you got an answer for us?
I have an answer, but I must have taken a hike mentally.
You didn't know it either.
Is very unusual for me.
Sure.
Front row.
No, I said strained it through a sock.
Well. All right. They just don't understand us, do they, Larry?
No, they don't.
Well, Larry and I understood it. Charles did, yes. You ready, Elizabeth?
I think I'm at a distinct disadvantage. He's a minister. He has a pretty big fan. So right. The pressure's on.
Well, you need two to tie and three to win.
Okay.
Doesn't seem like a very difficult assignment to me. Did you hear that the landlord tried to evict the old lady who lived in the shoe?
Oh.
Well, he had to use a blank to get her out. Ready, Chuck. Ready, Elizabeth.
I don't know.
Did you hear that the landlord tried to evict the old lady who lived in the shoe? He had to use a blank to get her out.
He had to use a sock? Oh. Scoop?
A scoop?
I know, Dean, I know. A hog, I don't know.
Your championship is safe.
Yeah, yeah, I think so. Yeah.
All right, Tom.
Oh, I thought it was going to be luck of the draw. What was her answer?
Sock.
Oh, well, I said shoehorn.
Shoehorn.
Oh, shoehorn.
Very good.
I think that's the definitive.
All right, Brett.
Oh, darling, I thought shoehorn was going to be a shoe-in.
Yeah.
Shoehorn.
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 Well, is it all over or what?
No, it's not all over.
Napkin.
She must match you and Joyce to achieve a tie.
I see. Well,
lots of luck.
I know Odor Eater ain't going to get nothing. So I said shoehorn. Sorry.
Shoehorn. So that means Larry wins the game. Why'd you have shoehorn? Right down there. Elizabeth, we're going to send you a cauliflower ear and a lump of coal. Thank you for being with us. Elizabeth Augustine.
Thank you.
It's been an awesome, similar message for you. Hurry back.
The brand new limited edition Disney Winnie the Pooh postage stamps are now available. The International Collectors Society is now offering the only collector set ever issued to commemorate the evolution of Winnie the Pooh from a real bear born in Winnipeg, Canada, to a cartoon icon beloved around the world. Demand for this limited edition set has been so overwhelming, experts are already predicting this set will be prized by you and your loved ones for generations to come. Not available at your local post office, you can only get them through this special television offer. The complete set of stamps is only $9.95. You'll also receive a numbered certificate of authenticity and a protective display holder. But that's not all. When you order, you'll also get this beautiful Disney Winnie the Pooh airmail stamp, an $8 value absolutely free. Remember, you get the legal tender Disney Winnie the Pooh stamps, a numbered certificate of authenticity and protective display holder, all for $9.95. And when you act now, you'll also receive this stunning Disney Winnie the Pooh airmail stamp, an $8 value, absolutely free. There's a limit of 6 per household. Call toll-free now.
Want thin? Get thin. The new Space Saver Thin Line by Proform. No other treadmill is like this. This thin, this sleek, this strong. So when you've reached the finish line folds out of your way. So get thin. The new Space Saver Thin Line by Proform.
Thin Line, motorized to keep you moving, cushioned to keep impact to a minimum, with motivational electronics that keep you on track. For free information or to order your Proform Space Saver Thin Line, call the number on your screen now.
Hi, I'm Nancy Sullivan.
And I'm Dave Nemeth. Join us on Game TV.
Our resident game show guru, Fred Westbrook, will pay us another visit.
That's right. He'll take calls from our viewers, so phone in and try to stump Mr. Game Show. And
Fred's also going to tell us about the game show, Tattletales.
Yeah, in fact, we have a question about Tattletales that will stump Fred.
Yeah? What is it?
All right, go ahead. You tell him.
No, the answer's Joe Garagiola.
How'd you know?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I should be called Ms. Game Show.
Normally, we go here month after month, year after year, and we're absolutely perfect. Occasionally, we make a mistake, and we made a minor mistake in this round of questions, the question that was given to Larry. The wrong person played. Tom played instead of Brett.
I was going to say Kill.
Actually, it did not affect the outcome in any way whatsoever, but we just thought we wanted to point out to you, in case some of you are sitting home there keeping score, don't write us any letters. We know we made a mistake. That's the end of it. I'll never talk about it again.
Okay.
I said I'd never talk about it again.
I wanted to change that. I thought, I wish I could remember what the question was that I did. I could not remember. But, of course, it was not my mind that was going. I hadn't answered it correctly.
That's right. Okay.
Well, that's nice.
Now, here, Larry, you're going to have another go at the big money here. We polled the studio audience. And we said, write down your best answer to this. I wish you were blank. All right. Three of the six stars will assist. You call out one at a time.
Brett?
I wish you were here, and you are.
Yeah.
I wish you were here.
Okay. Charles?
I wish you were Jewish. Is that all right?
No, that stinks. I wish you were dead.
I wish you were dead. But instead, I don't like to say it, but it probably is up there.
Dead. All right.
Dead,
okay, McLean?
So dead is now being used.
Dead is now being used, and here is being used.
I understand. Okay.
But Jewish isn't.
I'm Jewish. I wish you were Jewish is okay, huh?
Yeah.
No, I don't want to use that. My choice is I wish you were mine.
I wish you were mine.
Oh, that's a sweet. Oh, I love that.
All right. I wish you were mine, I wish you were dead, and I wish you were here, the three they've given you. Now, your option. Choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Here.
Oh,
here. All right, that's Brett's answer. Let's take a look at the $100 response. I wish you were dead. Is that Charles' answer? There it is. Next one says, I wish you were there. What is
there?
That?
Where is there?
There.
I wish you were there. What kind of a
that's
group
crazy.
Did we have that
day? Doesn't make any sense. Well, let's take a look at the top one right now. There! All right. Now, you've got another $500, Larry, and a chance for $5,000 or $10,000.
Oh, boy.
Which will it be? Let's go see. Give the spin a wheel there, the wheel of spin.
Double!
Wish you were here.
Okay. Yeah.
I know you are.
All right. Ready. Good luck. It's for $10,000. Rainy blank. Rainy blank. No help from the audience, please. All right. For $10,000, you have to match. What do you say to that?
Rainy day.
Rainy day. Okay. Dale, he says, rainy day will match you for the $10,000. What do you say to that?
What can you buy with $10,000?
Who's the lady with your wife?
One of her
name's Jan McCoy. She's a friend.
Oh, a friend of hers.
And then her sister over there. in between or after. I don't know. We're all having a good time. We're very happy for you. You got $11,000 altogether. Congratulations to you, Larry Bowles, ladies and gentlemen. There you go. And here comes Chris Broadhurst and Gwen Taylor. Hello, hello, hello.
Well, we've had a lot of excitement here because he just won a total of $11,000, $10,000 on this spin of the wheel, and I know he's very happy, and we welcome you and want to find out who you are and where you're from. Chris, please tell us about yourself.
Okay. I'm a real estate broker in Manhattan Beach, and in my spare time, I weight train and I play volleyball.
You wade what?
Weight train.
Oh, you weight train. Yeah. You have muscles?
A little bit.
Doesn't that cause a disfigurement in a lady?
Just tones your body.
Just tones your body. Mm-hmm. Good. All right. Glenn, tell us about you, please.
I'm a mediator for the state of Nevada, and I've been in the state of Nevada, preferably Reno area, for the last 10 years, and I have a beautiful wife. Her name is Gwen Taylor, and I have...
She has the same last name as you have.
Same last name. And I have three beautiful children, two boys and one girl. Glenn, Terry, and Sharia.
All right. Welcome to both of you. Good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
Chris, you make the first decision here.
I'll choose B.
Right. Tough Teresa, the Girl Scout, is really tough. Tougher than you, I'll tell you that. For that kind of work. Anyway, she's really tough. She's the only girl in her troop who has a blank. The only girl in her troop who has a blank.
She's a girl scout.
Yeah, tough.
I don't think that anybody's got it. I can't think of it.
Here we go, Chris.
No way.
Tough Teresa, the Girl Scout, is really tough. She's the only girl in her troop who has a blank.
Tattoo
is very good.
Really good.
Isn't that a wonderful answer?
Yeah. Very good.
Very good. You know, I come over here and I say, isn't that a wonderful answer? They say, oh, yeah, very good.
We're all so ashamed.
Why didn't we think of that? Okay, Tom, you're up.
Much better than mine, I'll tell you. I couldn't come up with that. It said whip.
Whip, all right.
Until I heard her answer, I kind of liked mine. So it was a vaguely mirth-provoking, but now I'm not so crazy about it. I said she was the only girl in her troop who had a pair of jockey shorts.
Huh. All right.
But that's awfully good.
She had a jock.
Wait, what? That's in bad taste.
I don't know what it means, and I'm not going to ask.
Well,
you're better off, darling.
Only I know some guys with tattoos, and they're not that tough, believe me.
Show me your tattoo.
Hello, Gail. Only girl in her troop who has a...
Well, I just couldn't think of anything, and since McLean has been doing so well all week with his answer...
You copied his.
I copied his answer. Hog.
Hog. There's a pet hog. Well, it would be difficult to carry that around on a leash.
Yeah, but you don't have to be tough for you hog fans out there to own a hog. I can put you in the ownership of a hog... Tax license and included right off the lot for about $15.95, and you don't have to be tough to handle that stuff.
Right.
Just write to me here in care of the...
Yes, right.
Match game.
Right,
show.
Right, right. Directly
Sprite
to McLean Seat. Hog, match game.
You
right.
Got it.
It'll all come to you. Right.
Right.
Not to me.
Oh, my answer. Yes.
Your answer.
I said, of course, a tattoo of a gun.
Didn't buy it. All right, Joyce.
Okay.
I said she was so tough. She was the only girl who had rubber Girl Scout cookies.
Tattoo was good. Gun was good.
Yeah.
Anything, you know, and you get black eye and all that sort of thing.
I don't understand Joyce's
answer. We'll be along in a moment with a question for you. Right now we have this for you. If
you can dust and dust, but you'll never get your home dust-free with these old-fashioned things. They just push the dust around. But now there's the Magna Duster, the incredible duster that works like a magnet. This extraordinary duster actually creates an electrical charge that attracts dust like a magnet. Look, you can actually see the dust as it's pulled off the surface and into the Magna Duster. Incredible! Watch again as the dust jumps off the table and into the Magna Duster. Those other dusters just can't get these shutters clean. But Magna Duster conforms to the tightest places, grabbing onto the dirt and holding it tight. Watch it work on these mini blinds. pulling the dust out of those hard-to-reach places just like a magnet. It's much faster than other methods. A table full of collectibles can be such a chore, but not anymore. The fibers actually reach out and grab the dust without disturbing a thing. Use it on all your electronics. Pull dust right off the TV. Magna Duster gets into those tight places other dusters can't go. Now you can dust your whole house in half the time. It's amazing. And the soft fibers come clean with soap and water. Try that with your feather duster. Call and get your Magna Duster today. Only $19.95 on this exclusive TV offer. But wait, you'll also get a second Magna Duster. Plus, we'll include the extended handle, perfect for those hard-to-reach places. And the Magna Duster is bendable, so you clean the top of ceiling fans or under the cabinets. There's more. You also get the mini Magna Duster, great for the car, perfect for the office. It's Magna Duster, the complete kit for the amazing price of just $19.95. It really is a dust magnet.
Have your credit card ready and call 1-800-391-9880. The incredible Magna Duster is just $19.95. Call 1-800-391-9880 or send check or money order to this address. But for a faster delivery, call right now, 1-800-391-9880.
Ready, Glenn. Thank you, John. Mm-hmm.
Joe said, you know the price of meat is too high when you come home and find your wife stuffing the blank for dinner.
Did you know why we've got time to fill here? Did you know that you can teach you to hug, shake hands?
You can. How do you do that?
We just have to be patient with them.
Oh.
You can teach them to fetch.
Really?
Yeah, these hugs that I have available for just a limited time will fetch, and you can take them anywhere.
Yeah, they're not too big. They're young, aren't they?
Well, they're not messy. These hogs aren't messy.
Oh, they're clean.
Sure.
Really?
They've never touched the ground. They keep them in little cages.
Oh. So they're not full of mud and all that.
See, a lot of the people that are in the audience may not know what we're talking about, but the folks at home will know.
That's right.
All the hog lovers of America will know.
Glenn, you ready?
I think I have to some of the time.
All right.
I hope I do.
The price of meat is too high when you come home and find your wife stuffing the blank for dinner.
The dog.
The dog, yeah. You fed the dog, Tom.
Yes, but you see, a dog is made up of meat.
Yeah.
Therefore, that's not that keen an answer, however it might very well be in comparison to this one. This one will not only eliminate the meat in your diet, but most anything else, but it's you just stuff one of those and you don't have to worry.
Stuffing the prune for dinner. All right.
There's a lot of Dick Martin in him.
That's right. A lot of...
Okay, sweetheart. Scully Mitchell, all those dumb guys who sit over here.
The OG sells dog!
All right.
Dog!
All right, two down.
Well, she was totally prepared because she was stuffing the pillow.
Uh-huh, the pillow. Gonna be delicious.
Yep.
You come home, find your wife stuffing the dog for dinner. What do you say, McLean?
I said the dog.
The dog. Three for Glenn. Joyce?
I said the parrot.
The parrot. A family pet. All right. Now, we go to round two, and Glenn, your head, you've got to go first.
I'll have A.
A it is. Ralph said, I'll never fly on that rotten airline again. The wine list was printed on the blank. All right, Glenn. Ralph said, I'll never fly on that rotten airline again. The wine list was printed on the blank.
Toilet paper.
That was not the first thing that came to my mind. What came to your mind?
The old Indian teepee.
Oh, yeah, it did. That's four for him. What do you say, Gail?
You should always go with your first impulse, because I thought toilet paper, and then I changed it to barf bag.
Barf bag. That was my first thought, yeah. Barf bag. What did you say, Joyce?
I certainly wouldn't say something like barf bag. The air stick bag.
Oh, yeah.
The air stick bag.
I put motion sick.
That's four for you and a chance to catch up for you later. Now this for you.
Sign up for Sprint Sense Dime a Minute right now, and your evenings and weekends will never be the same again. So I'm heading home from work, and suddenly... I'm in the dime zone. All at once, everyone's dog is getting off my lawn. The leaves start blowing into someone else's pool. And best of all my long-distance calls are just 10 cents a minute. With Sprint Sense, you're in the dime zone. Every weeknight from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. and all weekend long. So call now and get that great dime-a-minute rate when it makes the most sense. When you and the people you're calling have the most time to talk. It's a typical Saturday morning, but this time, my wife actually enjoys her chat with my mother. And when you sign up now, you'll also get an extra bonus, up to 100 minutes free. Sunday afternoon, my friends drop by and my wife insists they stay for lunch. My daughter even lets me use the phone. Sign up for Sprint Sense Dime a Minute right now and get up to 100 minutes free. Call now, 1-800-913-9719.
The average funeral today now costs over $4,000. But the most Social Security will pay to your survivors, if they qualify, is only $255, leaving your loved ones to pay the balance. If you're age 50 to 80, you can protect your loved ones with Montgomery Ward Life's Mature Life Plan. It pays cash expenses at your family's time of need.
It's important to know my wife or kids won't be burdened if anything happens to me.
I didn't have to take a physical. I didn't even have to answer any health questions.
With the Mature Life Plan, you enroll by mail, and you cannot be turned down for coverage.
I feel good knowing that we're protected by Montgomery Ward Life, a company we know we can trust.
Call now and get a free booklet explaining Social Security benefits and free information about the Mature Life Plan.
For free information, call 1-800-354-9797.
Attention bargain shoppers! For a limited time only, our very special customers like yourself will be offered The Price is Right with Bob Barker 7 days a week at 9 a.m. Eastern. Imagine your delight as you play along with Plinko, Any Number, and The Clock Game. In the Showcase Showdown, you may very well win a new car!
Not really, but you can't blame us for trying.
So tune in to The Price is Right and shop, shop, shop only on Game Show Network.
Hey, you're watching Game Show Network. Next up, it's Super Password, followed by Wheel of Fortune, and then Jeopardy!
Well, that's it, folks.
Oh, boy.
Wasn't it over in a hurry?
Hey,
yes,
it was.
What
the
bishop said to the
act. Gene, your broker just called pork bellies are up this week.
They are.
Yeah.
Hear that, McClendon?
29 cents a pound, I hear.
Yep.
Yep.
I tell you.
You picked the right one.
Life is hogs.
I'm going to tune in tomorrow, see how this works out, and see if that little Chris can possibly catch up with Glenn.
Yeah. The score is now 4-0.
I know.
In his favor.
So I'm going to watch.
Tune in tomorrow and see if Chris catches up to Glenn. Gene Rayburn here. Thank you. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive the new Shape of Pleasure, a light, sparkling, boldly sophisticated pink champagne. Takes you away from the ordinary pink champagne malt liquor from Iroquois brand. And Kraft Macaroni and Cheese Dinner has the cheese taste the kids enjoy. You know they're going to like it. Hall's Mentholiptus Cough Tablets. Hall's Vapor Action penetrates deep to help your stuffy nose feel clearer, while Hall's soothes your throat to help your cough. And Bowl of Beauty Real Rose is the ideal gift treated with the patented process that captures their soft, natural look, keeps them lovely for years. This is Johnny Olson.
Coming up, it's celebrity fun and excitement on Super Password with Bert Convy. Then buy some vowels with Pat Sajak on Wheel of Fortune, only on Game Show Network.
On Game Show Network, anyone can win terrific prizes like this. Create high-quality, easy-to-read labels in seconds with Croy's Little Labeler Plus. This handheld, battery-powered labeler is the ultimate tool for organization. From Croy. So, register now to play any of our interactive games. Call 800-537-GAME. It's fast, it's fun, and it's free. Just register once, and you can play forever on Game Show Network.
You're watching Game Show Network. You're watching Game Show Network.